Hi everyone, this is Am, a graphic design how-to, and today I'm going to tell you how to make a gear icon, or a settings icon, or cog, or whatever you want to call it. Alright, let's get started. Okay, I'm in Illustrator right now, and this is the gear that I've already created, so I'm going to show you how I made this. So let's hit Command-N, or Control-N on a PC, to get a new document. We'll go to Print, and Letter, and Create. All right, let's come over here to our shape tools. You'll probably have a rectangle here, but if you click and hold, you can see all the tools underneath, and we need to go to the star tool. And then we can just click and drag on our canvas. Now, before you let go ahead and hit the up arrow, and this will add a lot of points to your star. And that's what we want. We can also hold command to lengthen the segments. That's control on a PC. So I'm just going to make it something like this, and you can hold shift to get it back to straight, and then we'll release. I'm going to hit D on my keyboard to give it a fill of white and an outline of black, and then I'm going to switch those by hitting shift X, hitting X to bring the white to the front, and then the backslash to clear that. And now I'll hit V and move this a little more to the middle, and drag on a corner while holding shift. Just kind of make it a little bit bigger. Now I'll click L to get my circle tool. I'll draw a circle like this. I'm gonna copy and paste in front, and then make one a little bit smaller than this. Now, if we hit Command Y or Control Y on a PC, you wanna make sure that both circles are outside these little points here. Okay, and let's hit V, select everything, and then come over here to the Align palette, and horizontal align, and then vertical align. So everything should be lined up now. I'm going to hit Command Y again, and I'll hit Z to get my zoom tool and draw a box around this. Now you can kind of see how some of these parts might work pretty well for a gear. So I'm going to get my V tool. I'm going to click on this center circle, and I'm going to copy it with Command C or Control C on a PC, paste in front with Command F, Control F on a PC, and then I'm going to move this off to the side. So I'll hit V and return, and that'll bring up my move dialog box. I'm going to send it 1,000 pixels to the right with 0 vertical, and we'll say OK. So if we Command minus or Control minus and zoom out, we can see this other circle over here. Okay, let's zoom back in to our star shape. And now I'm going to hit V and select all of these. Then I'm going to hit Shift M, which will give us our shape builder tool. Okay, and now the first thing I don't want are all these spikes out here. So I'm going to hold Option and just draw hitting each of those spikes like this. And I want to combine all of these shapes in here. So without holding Option, I'll just draw and combine all of these like this. All right, now here are some pieces out here that I don't want. So I'm going to hold Option and just touch each one of those shapes. All right, so we have our cog wheel. I'm going to highlight everything with the V tool, which is right up here, your selection tool. And then we'll come down here to Pathfinder and unite these. Okay, now I'm going to Command minus, zoom out. That's Control minus on a PC. And I'll select this piece, and I'll hit V, return, and get my move tool back. And we'll send this minus 1,000 pixels or points to the left. And now it's exactly where it was before. Now I'm going to hit Shift and Option and drag on the corners until about right there and release. And now I'll use my V tool to select both of these, and we'll use the shape mode minus front. Now the way we just built this, this is all one shape. There aren't two shapes, meaning this isn't a white circle and a black cog. You can tell this by compound path right up here, and it's also in your appearance palette. If it says compound path, you're only dealing with one shape. So when you move it, it moves everything together. And it's as easy as that. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.